Oh yeah, I guess so.
That's a nice fish.
Oh jeez.
Oh, I just had one go for mine.
Oh.
Grab it, you dog.
They're double hitters.
Sometimes keeping it simple is really the best way to go.
I gotta laugh at those boats going way out.
Oh, that's crazy.
Salmon primarily feed on small bait fish. So it's no wonder that a simple lure that looks and acts like a vulnerable bait fish will stir a school of coho or silver salmon into a feeding frenzy.
Yeah, oh, that is cool.
That's a nice fish.
In the early 1980s, Pete Roscoe created what would become known as the crippled herring. After years of development in the waters off the coast of the Olympic Peninsula in Washington State. Since then, countless anglers have enjoyed success with the crippled herring, but now Pete Roscoe has taken that lure to a new level of color, action, versatility, and sonic vibration with the release of a new lure called the Sonic Baitfish, now distributed by Max Lure of Wenatchee, Washington.
That's a native, so I have to release it.
Bob Schmidt, general manager of Max Lure, has seen sonic bait fish work for kokanee, walleye, trout, and bass.
Oh, what a beautiful
but
fish.
This is his first experience with salmon. And what a fantastic day he's having with light tackle, simple lures, and hard-fighting coho. That if you're not careful, it'll pull you out of the boat. This week, we're salmon fishing in the Strait of Juan de Fuca near the town of Port Angeles, Washington, with Bob Schmidt of Max Lure.
Releasing for me,
yeah, Pete. Yeah, you betcha.
And Pete Roscoe, inventor of the crippled herring and now the sonic bait fish.
Nice fish.
I'm Justin Wolf, and this is Angler West Television.
Back in the early 80s, I created the crippled herring metal jig, and it caught a lot of fish. But over the years, we improved the action, especially, and it evolved into the sonic baitfish that you see now. And the unique thing about the sonic baitfish is the fact that you can fish it by attaching it to the nose, you can attach it to the tail, and you can also attach it to the third method, which is on the back. The back attachment gives you excellent sonic vibration. The nose and the tail attachment gives you excellent fluttering action. And you control it, swim jig it, vertical jig it, cast it, you can do anything with it.
First thing that morning, we started out trolling these lures not far offshore in about 250 feet of water.
Well, we're looking for our fish marks that are high. As a matter of fact, looks like we might have a salmon there at about 45 feet. We have one hook, but we like to see more than one hook. And if that's the case, we would stop and start vertical jigging. Vertical jigging is a lot more precise than what we're doing here as far as the trolling is concerned. So we want to see more of these hooks, get a concentration, and we'll go to vertical jigging. Right now, we're searching for salmon. Okay, this is how we cast. I'll cast perpendicular to our drift, or even a little ahead of our drifts, so that the lure has a chance to settle through the water column. And then just activate your reel, set her down. And basically what's happening is that lure is falling through the water column, and then once the boat passes the line, the tension picks up and that lure will start coming up, swimming up towards the surface. So we're doing two things here. We're trying to get the fish to hit on the fall and also on the rise. Swimming on the rise and flutter on the downward, on the downfall.
Got one.
Okay.
Little one.
Okay, good release. That's the advantage of a barbless hook. That was a small silver salmon. We're looking for something just a little bit larger.
When fishing the Port Angeles area, stay at the Olympic Lodge. The Olympic Lodge has big, comfortable rooms, a great pool and workout room, and it's only minutes from the boat ramps, restaurants, and shopping. Go to olympiclodge.com. We're fishing the waters off of Port Angeles, Washington, where we have our first hookup, but it's not quite what we're looking for.
That's the advantage of a barbless hook. That was a small silver salmon. We're looking for something just a little bit larger, like maybe 10 to 20 pounds. That would be nice.
Pete, you probably heard that old adage, you want bigger fish, use bigger bait. But I know you've always been a huge believer in using real small profile baits in a lot of cases. What's your
reasoning? Definitely, Bob. Over the years, I found out that smaller is better. As a matter of fact, my good outdoor writer buddy, Terry Rudnick, did a show at the Sea Aquarium many years ago in that regard. A lot of these fish, a lot of times, aren't that really active. And when they're not active, they don't want a big meal. They want a little snack. Mm-hmm. And so I found out, I try to use a lure as small as possible to reach my target. And I've been pretty successful over the years doing that. So small lures catch big fish.
We go. That's what we're looking for.
There you go. Nice.
Oh, come on, baby.
Procure.
Is that up to your standard yet? We still want to go a little bigger.
Probably a little bigger.
So we'll let him go?
I think we'll let him go.
We'll still have a little bit more fun with him here. Get some runs.
Silver salmon. Good release, Bob.
Here's the advantage of fishing an artificial bait. You release the fish. Seconds later, you're casting for another one.
I just start working the rod and dropped it back when that fish hit. Prior to that, I was just leaving it in the next to the rod holder doing nothing. And at times, take the rod when the fishing is slow. Take the rod and start working it back and forth. Move it forward and let it flutter back. Sometimes that little backward flutter, only less than a foot, makes all the difference in the world. It's a little better fish, but not what we're looking for as far as size is concerned. That's on the half ounce Sonic bait fish in the white glow finish. I love that finish. It's been so productive for anything. We're just gonna release it. Yeah, we got a lot of fish here. This is the first time we marked so many bait fish, regular fish. The bait fish and the salmon, it goes down to about 55, 60 feet. We need to get a little deeper, so we're going to use a diver, and this is going to get us down to about, we're trying to get down to maybe about 35, 40 feet. The fish marks are a little bit deeper right now. They're not up close to the surface, so Bob's going to use the Double D Dodger, and I'm just going to use the basic Sonic bait fish application. So we're going to see how we do. Diamond D and Sonic bait fish versus just a Sonic bait fish.
Fish on. Gonna make a Pete a believer in the Dodger now real quick.
Like I said, let's get that Double D Dodger on. Let me know if you need the boat maneuvered. I sure love that Double D.
Well, just in case you're wondering, Pete, that's 6-1. You might want to consider putting one on.
I won't do it unless it gets up to 20-1. You're just a lot more successful with the one versus the other.
The anchovy. Oh, I was using the anchovy.
Okay.
So it seems to be working well.
Okay. Just a little drop, right, Bob?
Yep.
I can't find really moving water. So we're gonna take a little run and look for the kelp beds, and we're going to fish the outer edges of the kelp beds for both salmon and for bottom fish. We're gonna be targeting king salmon, silver salmon, lane cod, and black rockfish. And we'll be vertical jigging with the sonic bait fish.
Welcome back to the Strait of Juan de Fuca. I'm Justin Wolf. Pete and Bob have hooked up about a half dozen coho out in open water, but now we're heading closer to shore.
Basically, what we're looking for now, naturally we're looking for the structure, but I want to see some bait fish on that structure, and even better, I would like to see some predator fish marks. And right now I'm not seeing it. It's a good structure, but no bait fish. Generally, when you're fishing, don't waste too much time. Try to find the bait fish before you even set a line. So this is what we're looking for now. We take a little bit extra time to find the bait fish, but it pays off. And we're starting to get marks near the bottom. So that's what we're looking for. You don't look like a Pacific herring. That's a great thing about these sonic bait fish, is the fact that you can get into pockets like this and vertical jig them, or you can even flick it out in a very confined area. Very, very effective. This is something that the trollers can't accomplish. And this is where it all is. You can't do any better than getting in these pockets and vertical jigging in the bait. Extremely effective. There's nothing more effective than that. You have to go back to that rock. Usually when I make drifts, if they're unproductive, I don't go a long way. This feels like a greenling here. What are you getting yours on, Bob? Got to use some of that pro cure.
I need a bow mount so I can spin us around.
That's a greenling. Excellent table fare.
Well, you didn't tell me we were greenling fishing. I thought we were salmon fishing. I'm fishing for salmon.
Never touch a fish if you can help it, if you're going to release it. One of the other things, when you have a real fast drift, these fish are on the bottom, cast into your drift. Give that lure a chance to settle towards the bottom, then bottom bounce it back towards you. That might be a lean cod there. Salmon. He's not big, but they're feisty. Silver salmon.
Now you got yours hooked on the nose?
Yeah.
Aha, I'm gonna switch from the back to the nose.
They're really responding to this the swimming action of that on that lure. Okay, let's release this guy. We were out there trolling for, I don't know how many hours, maybe 2 hours, 3 hours, and I think we maybe hooked a half a dozen fish. In less than 10 minutes, it's been, I think, 4 or 5 hookups, just with jigging, no trolling. It's such an easy way to fish also. Just cast it out, let the lure do the work, just hold on. This white finish is absolutely dynamite. It's never failed me yet. Just letting it drop, letting it swim. How's Bobby doing over there?
Doing good, I still got a lead. Fun, fun.
Wonder why it's not jumping. Do you have the white one on, Bob?
I do.
Okay. As soon as he hits the water, tight line it. This is called dead sticking. Just missed him. We're about 54 feet of water here. I'm gonna fast retrieve and see if I can entice one here.
Got one.
Man, I wish you would have shown me the spot sooner, Bob. Well, those fish have a lot of heart.
Let him go. Ready for me to let him go? Goodbye. Come on, get off there.
He's like my cat. He's not listening. There we go, Bobby.
You might need your stick to get him loose there. Let go of that.
Okay, I'm gonna find the stick.
You do got a better release technique than I do, that's for sure, Pete.
Okay, let's bring it up while I got this other fish on.
Thank you, sir.
Like I said, let the lure do the work. And believe it or not, you can catch Chinook salmon up to 32, 35 pounds fishing this way. We just happen to be in with a few silvers. But when you have a light tackle, this is a great sport.
When fishing the Port Angeles area, stay at the Olympic Lodge. The Olympic Lodge has big, comfortable rooms, a great pool and workout room, and it's only minutes from the boat ramps, restaurants, and shopping. Go to olympiclodge.com. Welcome back to the salmon-infested waters not far from Port Angeles, Washington, on the Olympic Peninsula. We've caught lots of coho, and while we've not found any in the 20-pound range that we'd like to see, the size of the coho has definitely increased after we moved closer to shore. But on this day, the sizable fish all turned out to be wild.
Grab in there for me, yeah. Pete. Yep.
So we're not having coho for dinner just yet.
We want to make sure it's a native fish. You can't keep a...
Can't keep him?
No, I'm not saying that. You can't keep a native. It's a native. See that adipose fin? It's not clipped, so we have to release it. Right here is the adipose fin. That has to be clipped. Okay. Bob, why don't you catch a hatchery fish that we can keep? The color of the sonic bait fish, we refer to it as a white glow. And it's a UV glow, and it actually works in low light periods, bright light periods. It works. This is my favorite finish right here. I do extremely well with it, and this is my first go-to finish. And it's a consistent winner. There we go.
Fishing close to shore among the kelp beds not only produced good numbers of salmon, but also lots of other resident fish like greenling, black rockfish, and the occasional lingcod.
That's fun.
It's important to read the regulations, as in this area, many of these species need to be released.
The double hitters.
The sonic bait fish is a simple little lure to fish that sure is effective. If you'd like to learn more about the sonic bait fish, then visit the Max Lure website today.
I
Double hitter.
Oh,
that is cool.
That's a nice fish.
Thanks for watching today's episode of Angler West TV. You know, it's only with the sponsor support that this show is made possible, so please thank them when you can. Now get out there and do some great fishing. When fishing the Port Angeles area, stay at the Olympic Lodge. The Olympic Lodge has big, comfortable rooms, a great pool and workout room, and it's only minutes from the boat ramps, restaurants, and shopping. Go to OlympicLodge.com.